G-Talks Podcast.
We got another one, another one, and another one, baby. This is G-Talks Podcast, episode one. And we finally here, brother, man. I got some good brothers in the room right now. I'm telling you, man, I had to go from earth into back. I'm telling you, man. We got some good brothers. We got OG in the building.
Yo,
my nigga O in the building.
What up, what up?
I'm telling you, man. Some good brothers right now. We're going to have some good topics that we're going to talk about for today. And, you know, it's definitely needed in this world right now because a lot of people just not keeping it honest. They're keeping it real, you know? And that's just where I'm at with it, man. So what's going on, OJ?
You know, in the news, we've had a couple things going on lately. And, you know, everyone's talking about it. No one isn't talking about it.
Right.
And it's a sensitive subject. And so let's just dive right into it. Mm-hmm. So Saturday, you know, we know what happened in El Paso, Texas.
Yeah.
Man went on a rampage.
Yeah, I heard about that. I seen it.
Killed how many people?
Like 50 people? He killed 20. 20,
nah,
20
he shot up to almost 50 people.
Yeah.
Probably killed 21 people, right?
Yeah. About 22 people.
Right, 22? Right, right.
Yeah.
And the cops got there.
Yeah.
Cops got there, right?
Yeah.
And he had a gun.
Yeah.
And he turned himself in.
Yeah.
He's alive. Now in
alive.
He's alive. Now Dayton, Ohio, same night, actually the next day, which was the 4th, I believe. Which would have been early in the morning, you know, after club hours. We all know how that goes. But in this situation, the man kills 9, and the cops get there within 30 seconds. He killed 9 people in 30 seconds. But
ridiculous.
The cops killed him.
Mm-hmm.
Cops killed him.
Mm-hmm.
So let's talk about this for a second.
Right? Talk about it.
Let's talk about it for a second.
Mm-hmm.
Now, we've had a lot of incidents over the last, let's just say, let's cap it off in 5 years. You know what I mean? We could go back to Trayvon Martin if we wanted to. That's a little bit further back. But we're going to cap this in about 5 years.
Five?
Maybe 5 years.
Okay.
So, now just as recently, Guap, what was the young man's name who was choked out over the water? What was his young man's name?
His name was Eric Gardner. He died in New York City July 17th, 2014 in Staten Island, and he was killed by Daniel Patelio NYPD, and it was on foot.
You know what, though? Now, if you remember this, though,
by Waters,
think back.
Waters and Lucy's.
This man was selling Lucy's.
Lucy's.
And also
Lucy's.
Water.
Lucy's cigarettes. Lucy's cigarettes. Now, you know, we all got to hustle,
mm-hmm.
right? And he ain't bothering nobody but a smoker. Right? I mean, you know.
Now, that's what Americans speak. It's fucked up, man. It's fucked up. That's what they saying a lot by their actions.
Well, right? Well, now think about it. In the footage, he didn't have no gun.
Yeah.
At all.
And now, he was a big guy. Okay? Now, let's go over the facts of the matter. I was a big guy. But in no way did he swing at the cops. He didn't kill nobody.
Right.
Because he would just sell. Well, maybe you could get cancer from cigarettes, but that's not intentional. I mean, he didn't have a gun. He wasn't shooting people down.
Right.
And he was literally crying in the video, "You're choking me.
Stop.
I can't breathe."
Begging for his life. The man was begging for his life.
But he died. So, now think about it and draw a parallel between what just happened. In most situations, right, police shootings end up like El Paso.
Right.
And it seems to be that the shooter, most of the time, is always white. That goes around serial killing and doing these wild kinds of things. And they're not taken in, you know, they're taken in alive. So now think about it. What's the difference between a man who's selling cigarettes and not hitting me or attacking me, but I'm fearing for my life, so I got to choke him out. Then on the other parallel, you got a man who got a rifle and just killed 22 people. Now, aren't you fearing for your life with the guy who just killed 22 people?
And that's the bullshit, man. That's the bullshit, man. It's just like, you're saying a lot by these actions, man. You're like, you kill somebody for selling Lucy's, you know what I mean? You kill somebody, you know what I mean? You kill somebody for telling you that he has a gun in his glove compartment and he's just letting you know, and you shoot the guy up. You shoot the guy up. There's been cases guys had guns, but there's been a lot of cases guys been persecuted, you know, with that. And, you know, it's just fucked up, man. It's just like, you know, he can have it, but we can't, you know. And it's just that type of ordeal. And it's just fucked up, which has happened in El Paso. The guy put his AK-47 on the ground. Now, tell me this. National Guards, which are trained to kill. Trained to kill. They're trained. They're not trained to talk. That's the policeman's job, to deal with the people. They're trained to kill. Now, you telling me the police officers, the first one on the scene. So then it goes from the state trooper. From the state trooper, it goes to the National Guards. That's the branch line of situations. So you telling me it went through a couple branches.
And he was brought in alive.
And you was brought in alive. So why couldn't a police
officer... He's eating meals tonight.
Killed all them people.
He's being fed tonight, actually.
Killed all them people. Ain't nothing happened.
Ain't nothing happened to him. That's
fine. Think about that. You know? So, now, oh, earlier today, you were talking about Trump going down to El Paso.
Yeah, they ain't want him.
Now, what happened there? What happened?
They ain't want him. They ain't want him down there.
Now, why don't they want him down there? You know, now, think about that.
Right. But listen. I want to go back. We're going to get to that, you know. We're going to get to Trump. I want to take it back to you just saying about the cop killers.
Right.
That's what we're just going to put it out there, the cop killers. Yeah. I mean, not cop killers, excuse my language. Killer cops.
You know what I'm saying?
Killer cops. That's all it is. My thing is, the rage. Where's the fucking rage coming from? You feel what I'm saying? Let's go deep. I want to go deep with it. You feel what I'm saying?
We want to get to the root of the problem.
Where's the rage coming from?
A lot of the
high profile motherfucking stories that we've been seeing in the news since 2014 and 13 and all that shit. Since the shit really been hitting the fan on the news and everything with the phones and all this shit.
Right.
You feel what I'm saying?
Right.
Yeah. A lot of the fucking cases been younger cops. Not older cops like down south, the old white man and shit. Yeah. Straight races and shit, you feel me? The redneck cop and shit.
It's been younger cops.
Younger cops and shit. Where is all the fucking rage coming from? You feel what I'm saying? Is it in the blood? Like, come on, man. Where's all the rage coming from? Where is it coming from?
What you got to ask yourself?
Everybody been saying that, the easiest outlet, people have been saying for years, they probably been bullied in high school and all that shit. Not all them motherfuckers and shit. You feel what I'm saying?
You're right.
Not all them motherfuckers and shit. But when they finally get a little bit, some type of authority with that gun and that badge and shit, they just wild out. And they've been beating the fucking cases.
And half of them don't have a degree or nothing.
They ain't got
at all in law.
Still, it's the point, bro. It's the point.
It's the point.
It's the fucking rage, man.
It's the entity. It's where it's coming from. Where
you can't, you can't wait to shoot down a nigga, take a motherfucking life. But you take that old talking about serving, protecting all that. You just take motherfucker. You know that motherfucker ain't had no gun and all that shit. Shot him down like
he was
a dog.
We all know what's going on. They serve and protect a certain group of people.
Come on,
man. It's saying a lot, man. It's saying a lot, man.
Well, maybe KRS-One was right. Maybe overseers are now officers. And maybe we're all on the same plantation. Now think about that for a minute.
Listen, man.
It's a control system. They're going to control you what they fear. They will. And the police aren't actually the police.
And that's where I'm going to take it. That's where I'm going to take it to right now. It's either two outlets for them. Let's keep it real. It's only two outlets for them. You can change. You can act. You can act. You know what I'm saying? And do some shit. Motherfuckers really start getting together and wild the fuck out and all that shit. Technically. You know what I'm saying? Be all in the streets with it. Take it to them.
Just go LA with it.
Yeah, just go LA with Rodney King with it. Yeah, you can do that. You can do that and keep doing it.
Well, California done showed people that.
Hold on. You can somehow manipulate them and try to change their way of thinking. You feel what I'm saying? Mm. You change their way of thinking, then you gain the power.
Mm. Good point.
You feel what I'm saying? It's only two ways with it. Mm. So motherfucker got to think about that shit. Now you can break it down in only two categories. You know you ain't going to wild out, so you might as well get down with the movement and start trying to change their way of thinking. Mm. Even if it don't affect our generation, man, 9-10 times, man, let's look at our culture, let's look at our people. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I can look at all people, but let's look at our people, because we speaking against them any goddamn way, you feel me? To be technical, but now a lot of them got kids now. They gonna have kids and shit, you feel me? Grandkids and shit, great-grandkids and shit, you feel me? And going down the line and shit, you feel me? Because if we don't do something now, the shit is really going to get worse. It's going to be motherfuckers to get, it's probably going to be worse than Trump to be elected in office and shit sometime in the future. You feel what I'm saying? But our people's got to go through it. You feel me? Like, goddamn, like, so, you know.
What's it going to take to do that, though?
For people to really start getting on the same page. Like, somehow, some way. I ain't got the full answer. I'm just saying. However they gonna do it, people really gotta start listening, open up their motherfucking mind and stop having a one-track mind and shit.
I feel like we have to change the old ways of things.
You feel me? Like,
because
change the whole system.
The system, the politics,
everything.
Look at this electoral college shit, bullshit. Like,
bro, look at this box.
Everything.
Why y'all just said that? I'm just looking at this iPhone box. Hmm. Not everybody, but a lot of people in society, they can't wait for that fucking iPhone to come out. That bitch $1,100.
You ain't lying.
$1,200 and shit. You get some type of discipline with you.
Right.
You like, I ain't.
There's no discipline.
I ain't riding with society. You're correct. I ain't riding with society and all that shit.
You so I'm going to wait till the price go down.
Or get me another joint way less than that.
That's just as good.
Then you save the money. You start finding ways to save money and shit.
Like, so then what if we're living in a system that wants all that? That wants that control over everybody? And by getting control and keeping control, there's only one way to do that, is divide everybody. So everybody ain't talking the same thing. See, the Boston Tea Party was a breakout when America was tired of being taxed. Mm. And it's written in our Constitution that we don't like what's going on. We could change it. But what is it really going to have to take to do that? You think people can get together overnight? It's going to take a lot.
Yeah.
It's going to take a lot.
Yeah.
And the movement, people quit at civil rights.
They
tricked everybody and thought, oh, you got your civil rights. Well, guess what? Money controls the world.
But that's the word. That's the word we've been hearing for years, you know.
Yeah.
But they got to start meaning something. We've been hearing.
Completely.
We've been hearing the movement. Somebody got to spark the movement. Once they spark the movement, people start joining. People start submitting themselves. You gotta submit yourself. Like, man, fuck.
It's sad to say, but I'm looking how history, what happened in history, like, what happened with peace and what happened with violence? What happened with peace?
Well, can we talk about history? Can we talk about history? The country we live in, which I love, by the way, the United States of America. I love this country because you know what? Go to a third world country, which we call a third world country,
right?
And check out the way they have to live.
Yeah.
Right? Now, but that's one side of the coin because there's two sides to every coin.
Yeah.
Now, in actuality and in all truth, America was formed by all immigrants that came from all walks of life who took the land.
Yeah.
And basically, over time, got rid of all the Indians or pushed them all out into Mexico.
Yeah. Right? I believe that.
Right. So
I believe that.
Everything that I found out in life, if it starts off fucked up, it ends up fucked up. It's just like a bad relationship. And parallel to that, to a female.
Right.
You meet a chick, but, yo, she's with a dude and you with a girl and y'all get together. Well, y'all some cheating ass motherfuckers. Mm-hmm. Yo, that's just gonna end up the same way. Yo, it could probably be some good sex for a minute. Or be some good shit going on. But guess what? At the end of the day, is that gonna work? Because it probably will end up how the fuck it started off. Because there's always a beginning and an end, and they all come kind of in the same fashion now. Damn, parallel that to the way this country was taken. Right. Now, this country was taken by force. But then we had a government over us. And then the next thing you know, we did the Boston Tea Party and we separated from that government and created this country. And here we are now. So whoever had control from the beginning, right, which you have a lot of original presidents and the guys that were the richest people, George Washington, Benjamin Franklin, John Adams, them dudes had money. You feel me? I'm talking about, you know, just imagine, ain't shit out here, but lords from England over here with cake, old money, in a new land, and they're ready to develop. They were businessmen. But they made the Constitution, and they made the laws. Now look, hey, look, they sound good, don't they? They do. When you read the Constitution and the laws on paper, right? It gives you, and I mean this, that's why I love America, right? It makes you feel, wow, I got rights. Wow, I got a chance. Wow, no, I'm a man. But there's a flip side to that coin, because that's only dependent upon how much money you got.
Right.
You got a man, and look, we said we were getting back to Trump, and it's some real shit if you think about it. Really, think about it. Think about this shit. Donald Trump is the president. Think about that for 1 second. Please think about this. Because
you're fired.
No, listen.
You're fired.
He's the president. Firing motherfuckers on TV.
Right.
Acting a fool. Wearing a toupee. You know that shit's fake. Saw the wind blowing.
Man, Muggsy.
Yo, listen.
Yeah.
But listen. But look, what does he have?
This is what I'm trying not to say, because I remember all that goofy shit. You feel me? Like, when
he's on
TV and shit, like, what was the show called again?
What was the show? The Apprentice?
The Apprentice.
The Apprentice.
That was good, dog. That's the shit right there.
Yo, he was firing more motherfuckers left and right.
Yo, listen, right?
Come on, man.
He's the president.
You're fine.
He's the president.
Making a fool of himself, but he was getting that money, though. They start paying him crazy. The people start tuning in.
Yo, let me say something. No. Hold on.
How many seasons of...
Donald Trump didn't need to get paid crazy, though, because I tell you why.
How many seasons of...
His dad left him an empire. His dad made...
His
pop was big in Manhattan. He was Manhattan, New York, his daddy.
Okay.
Money. Don wanted to make a name for himself. You could read his history. He had something in common with George Washington and the original presidents. He was a businessman. But he's the president, not knowing anything about ruling over people. Why is he the president? What does he got?
He
got money.
The
Apprentice was good on TV.
The Apprentice
had ran for a while. He's a colorful character. I'm not saying in a good way. I'm saying as entertainment.
Yeah.
You could sit there and trip off of him, smoke a little.
Got that attention, like, he's a mob nigga.
He's
the mafia. Like.
I didn't say that, but shit, just ask the question. How's he own casinos in Atlantic City forever?
Exactly.
All right, but we're going to leave that there.
Today.
Because we want to get this podcast going. All right?
All right.
We don't want no trouble. But, you know, so here you go. He's the president. And let's just say it. He's a mobster. So let's just say this man is a millionaire. And he done swindled so many people and cut so many throats to get to the top. Not physically, but, business-wise. Look. He stepped on anybody to get to the top, and he's there. He's the president of the free world, United States of America. Now that
It's fucking crazy.
It's crazy. I can't grasp that.
It's fucking
that.
Crazy, man.
So now, here we go with all these cop problems. And by the way, the person who's running the country is very questionable.
Yeah.
But I got a slant on him, right? And I feel like this is just my opinion. Because I've seen racists. I'm old enough to have seen mugs that don't like people.
Yeah.
And they were money, but they tell you.
Listen.
They tell you because they were rich and they didn't give a fuck. He don't like you if you don't got no money. It don't matter who you are. If you don't got no money, you ain't shit to Donald Trump. You ain't nothing.
Listen, excuse me. I don't want to cut you off.
Nah, you ain't.
The Apprentice TV series 2004 to 2017.
That's 13 years. Now, in fact, yo, that's 13
years. 13 years of a TV show.
And listen, what was the top ratings on that show? That show was, how was that show rated against the shows it was up against?
And just, I want to let y'all know,
we're talking about Survivor.
We got to let the viewers know, too, that we're just real good, man.
We're just real. So you're in our conversation, which is our daily, because we keep that shit real daily. And we talk about real shit all the time because you know what? Mm-hmm. If you ain't aware of what's going on around you and in the world, you're asleep. All right?
Straight.
Now, sit on that for a minute, too. Yeah. Oh, as far as The Apprentice, though, that was the top show on TV, man. It was up against good shows.
Yeah.
04 to 17?
Yeah.
And,
but understand.
Yeah.
He ain't saying nothing wrong, but hell yeah. You feel what I'm saying? For it to stay on that long. You feel me?
That was a long time. That's like Survivor.
Yeah, 13 seasons.
No, by the way, there were shows. Look, we're talking about American Idol was running at that time hard. And so was The Apprentice. And people were competing with getting to the TVs to watch Donald Trump talk shit to people.
Listen, it's no comparison, but I mean, it's just numbers thrown out there. That's like Martin. You feel me?
Right.
We all know one of the greatest comedy shows.
I love Martin.
On
man.
TV. Period.
Love Martin.
Yeah.
Was only on for.
He put a lot of comedians.
Listen, but that was the show.
Was only on for 6 seasons.
But that was a good show.
Was only on for 6 seasons. You feel what I'm saying? Labeled great. Man. Everything. Still getting a lot of money off that shit.
Yeah.
But then, fucking The Apprentice, Donald Trump shit. Was on from 2004 to 2017.
And I'm gonna tell you, listen to this. I'm gonna go out there on a limb. I think after a while he
stopped. His daughter Ivanka started doing this shit.
You know what I mean?
He's still getting.
That paper was there. You had a Trump there. That name. Look. Trump is their family name. It's not just him. So when you say Trump, he got kids. His daughter is as powerful as him and just as smart. She's smarter than her brothers. And she's fine as shit, by the way. Look her up, shit. Ivanka hot as shit. I'm going to be real. And she don't get naked and do crazy because she's a million billionaire businesswoman that cuts deals and will fire you like her dad.
Mm.
You feel me? So, and I know, listen, to everyone listening to the podcast, we start off with our topic because, see, that's how we roll. You know how you have stuff on your mind and you can't wait to get around your boys to really talk about it and get some opinions, you know what I mean? And let me tell you, in the future, and pretty soon, hopefully, you'll be able to call in and talk with us and see what's going on and add your little bit to what was going on.
Yeah, no doubt.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
But one thing we got to ask you to do, when that happens, you got to call in and keep it real. We don't have a problem with you cursing or saying some real shit on here. But you ain't going to call and just try to troll nobody because this is some serious stuff. We're talking about real shit all the time.
Always. And it's G-Talks, man. It's that gangster talk, man. It's that gangster talk. You know what I'm saying?
So, looking back at how we originally opened up, question, right? And think about this. This is a good question, too. We know what's going on. See, the hood don't lie, and the hood knows what's going on.
Yeah.
And you're right, oh. If everyone rose up that just said, fuck it, no more. Yo, listen, yeah. You see the Civil War, how that was? Where we're at right now?
Everybody got to stop being.
And that was a drawn line.
Like,
listen, the Civil War, and this is keeping it real, the Civil War was a line, though, the Mason-Dixon line.
Yes.
But this would be a different kind of thing because it'd be like, the war would be everywhere.
I'm talking about the Bloods, the Crips.
Oh,
everybody got to stay in the game.
And I would pray in my heart that nothing like that would happen.
As
we could come to a conclusion.
Mm-hmm.
But you got to, you know, the question is, we need to work and talk about it more and the realness of it.
Yeah.
You can't be scared to say what you really feel, right?
Right.
Because if you are, and if you're biting your tongue, then you're really not being real, and you'll never really get to the realness of the problem or any kind of solutions. See, because I had an OG tell me all the time, there ain't problems, there's only solutions. And that's like saying, my glass is half full instead of half empty. You know what I mean? But on a side note, yo, if you think it's half empty, then get a smaller cup, then fill that up, and then keep going. You know what I mean? But bottom line is, not well, you got to be able to adapt in life. So, you know, what the solutions we need to work on, it's broad. It's broad because we're talking about hundreds of years of gradually the same stuff, except now it's a control system that can do the same damage.
Yeah.
You feel what I'm saying? And look at that. Now, what is that there?
That's like a day or two. That's like a day or two after
that was in Times Square.
Yeah.
Yeah, you know what's crazy? And this is it. Now, is that where America is right now? Now, in Times Square the other day.
It's another one when they're in the mall or something.
In the mall.
And you know the thing, the little signs.
Yeah.
Little metal signs, you know what I mean? Probably got the cell or something with a picture with a lady on it or something. One of them things fell. In the mall, people start running and everything.
Wow. Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? That's what they said on CNN or something like that. Is this what the world is this what the United States is coming to? Like,
well, do you know? Could you imagine what foreigners think about this country? What is this country coming? What is it really coming to? When you can't even go in public, you hear a firecracker go off, everyone's running.
Exactly.
Running. I mean, that's,
scared,
you know.
Scared to death.
Right.
They're scared to death. Like,
correct.
Everybody's on edge. You know what I'm saying?
Well, how did it get this bad so shortly after Obama was just the president and there was this air?
I seen Obama. Right. I seen when he was talking after the whole campaign when Trump won. It was like a smack in the face.
Yo, in fact, I'm going to flash you back, Guap. Because, see, we're going to start to feed you in as this podcast goes on who we are. And I got you.
Man, you know we roll with it, man.
Now, Guap, I'm going to give you a flashback. Now, the Phillies won the World Series.
Right.
So we're all down at the parade. And you remember the hype of that day of the parade.
Oh, my God.
But what was the other hype? The happiness and joy when the Obama truck came through. Because he was running for president.
I actually have pictures, though.
Yo, listen, we don't got to get that deep yet, right? But we'll let the audience know who we are as it goes. But that's going to take some time, you know, because we're real at G-Talks. And, you know, on the street, we don't fuck with people we just meet. You know that. So you ain't really, you know, as it breaks down, you always hear the truth. But you'll get to know us. But anyway, back to this point. There was a happiness in the air. And I think it was a wind of change.
Yeah.
When Obama became president, right?
Yeah.
And what happened? Where did that go?
That shit.
On some real shit, where did that go? Where did that feeling go?
It went left. It was like the whole street, the whole city just intercepted. Like, you know what I mean? It was like, you know what I mean? Everybody was one. It was unity.
Well, that day. But where did that energy go all of a sudden, because Obama left office, and I swear,
oh, where did it go?
It was like America was at a funeral.
It went over.
It was like everyone was sad.
Grave, man.
Yeah. Well, then maybe we need to figure out what the problem is.
Yeah.
And get to the bottom root of it. And get some results out of this and make change really where it really is. And get down and really where, you know what I mean? Yeah. Again, I lean back to Trump because at this point, right, he's the president of the country. And now, and I'm not saying this stuff hasn't been going on because some of that stuff, if I remember Trayvon Martin case was while Obama was president.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
At that time, it could have been... You know, Obama could have. I think people were criticizing Obama at the time for not speaking up as much.
As much.
So, right. So, but there still was a wind of change. It was like.
Well, okay. I heard something from somebody.
Okay.
His name was Dr. Umar Johnson. He told some pretty good facts. He said when George Bush was in office, he. Changed the law called the Faith Initiative Act with the churches.
Right.
And that's, just think about it. In the Civil Rights Movement, how the churches just was involved with the Civil Rights so much. The churches, you know, they was meeting there, they had meetings there. They was thinking their next, come on man, don't be greedy, guap.
guap have a tendency, I'm sorry. Guap have a tendency of holding a blunt too long. Go ahead, man.
So the Faith Initiative Act really fucked it up when everybody started getting killed. Because it was like, where was the churches? Where was the churches doing all this bullshit as well? Mm. Well, the Faith Initiative Act is the federal government paying for the bills.
Right, right, right.
So
you're depending on the government then.
Yeah.
So, yeah. All of a sudden, we need them. Now we need them for our survival. You say, well, ooh.
Just think about it.
Wow. Man. Think about that for a second. Well, people, listen. This is our first podcast at G Talks. And, you know, we hope you enjoyed our time and your time with us. You know, at the end of the day, we're going to sit here and talk about some real shit. And we want your input once our website is up and we have more forum to let you communicate with us so that we can put on the right podcast for you and keep it real with the real stuff that's going on. Not people just getting on here to be famous, but people who are really trying to tell the truth.
And you can check us out at gtalks.podbean.com.
Yes, you can.
gtalks.podbean.com.
Remember, if you ain't keeping it real, you ain't shit.
Straight like that.
G Talks Podcast. I'm so in love with you. But.